Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. like you appears. Is there any greater glory?
You don't mean to say Gwendolyn refused you?
Oh, Gwendolyn's as right as a trivet. As far as she's concerned, we're engaged. But her mother is perfectly unbearable. Never met such a gorgon. I don't really know what a gorgon is like, but I'm quite sure that Lady Bracknell is one. At any rate, she's a monster without being a myth, which is rather unfair. Oh, I beg your pardon, Algy. I suppose I shouldn't talk about your own aunt like that before you.
My dear boy, I love hearing my relations abused. It's the only thing that makes me put up with them at all. Relations are simply a tedious pack of people who haven't got the remotest knowledge of how to live, nor the smallest instinct about when to die.
Oh, that's nonsense. You don't think there's any chance of Gwendolyn becoming anything like her mother in about 150 years, do you, Algy?
All women become like their mothers. That is their tragedy. No man does. That's his.
Is that clever?
It's perfectly phrased and quite as true as any observation in civilized life should be.
I'm sick to death of cleverness. Everybody's clever nowadays. You can't go anywhere without meeting clever people. The thing's become an absolute public nuisance. I wish to goodness we had a few fools left.
We have.
I should extremely like to meet them. What do they talk about?
The fools? Oh, about the clever people, of course.
What fools?
By the way, did you tell Gwendolyn the truth about your being Ernest in town and Jack in the country?
My dear fellow, the truth isn't quite the sort of thing one tells to a nice, sweet, refined girl. What extraordinary ideas you have about the way to behave to a woman.
The only way to behave to a woman is to make love to her if she is pretty, and to someone else if she's plain.
Oh, that's nonsense.
What about your brother? What about the profligate Ernest?
Oh, before the end of the week I shall have got rid of him. I shall say he died in Paris of apoplexy. Lots of people die of apoplexy quite suddenly, don't they?
Yes, but it's hereditary, my dear fellow. It's the sort of thing that runs in families. You'd much better say a severe chill.
Well, sure, a severe chill isn't hereditary or anything of that kind.
Of course it isn't.
Very well, then. My poor brother Ernest is carried off suddenly in Paris by a severe chill. That gets rid of him.
But I thought you said that Miss Cardew was a little too much interested in your poor brother Ernest. Won't she feel his loss a good deal?
Oh, that's all right. Cicely's not a silly romantic girl at all, I'm glad to say. She's got a capital appetite, goes long walks, and pays no attention at all to her lessons.
I would rather like to see Cicely.
I shall take very good care you never do. She's excessively pretty, and she's only just 18.
Have you told Gwendolyn yet that you have an excessively pretty ward who is only just 18?
Oh, one doesn't blurt these things out to people. Cicely and Gwendolyn are perfectly certain to be extremely great friends. I'll bet you anything you like that half an hour after they've met, they'll be calling each other sister.
Women only do that when they have called each other a lot of other things first. Now, my dear boy, if we want to get a good table at Willis's, we really must go and dress. I'm hungry.
I never knew you when you weren't.
What shall we do after dinner? Go to a theatre?
Oh, no, I loathe listening.
Well, let's go to the club.
Oh, no, I hate talking.
Well, we might trot round to the Empire at 10.
Oh, no, I can't bear looking at things. It's so silly.
Well, what shall we do?
Nothing.
It's awfully hard work doing nothing. However, I don't mind hard work where there is no definite object of any kind.
Miss Fairfax.
Gwendolyn, upon my word.
Algy, kindly turn your back. I've something very particular to say to Mr. Worthing.
Really, Gwendolyn, I don't think I can allow this at all.
Algy, you always adopt a strictly immoral attitude towards life. You're not quite old enough to do that yet.
My own darling.
Ernest, we may never be married.
Oh.
From the expression on Mama's face, I fear we never shall. Whatever influence I ever had over Mama, I lost at the age of 3. But although she may prevent us from becoming man and wife, and I may marry someone else and marry often, nothing that she can possibly do can alter my eternal devotion to you.
Dear Gwendolyn.
The story of your romantic origin, as related to me by Mama with unpleasing comments, has naturally stirred the deeper fibers of my nature. Your Christian name has an irresistible fascination. The simplicity of your character makes you exquisitely incomprehensible to me. Your town address at the Albany I have. What is your address in the country?
The Manor House.
The Manor House.
Woolton.
Woolton.
Hertfordshire.
Hertfordshire.
There is a good postal service, I suppose. It may be necessary to do something desperate. That, of course, will require serious consideration. I will communicate with you daily.
My own one.
How long do you remain in town?
Till Monday.
Good. Algy, you may turn round now.
Thanks, I've turned round already.
You may also ring the bell.
You will let me see you to your carriage, my own darling.
Certainly.
I will see Miss Fairfax out, Lane.
Yes, sir.
A glass of sherry, Lane.
Yes, sir.
Tomorrow, Lane, I am going Bunburying.
Yes, sir.
I shall probably not be back till Monday. You can put up my dress clothes, my smoking jacket, and all the Bunbury suits.
Yes, sir.
I hope tomorrow will be a fine day, Lane.
It never is, sir.
Lane, you're a perfect pessimist.
I do my best to give satisfaction, sir.
There's a nice, sensible, intellectual girl. The only girl I could ever care for in all my life. What on earth are you so amused at?
Oh, I'm a little anxious about poor Bunbury, that is all.
If you don't take very good care, your friend Bunbury will get you into a serious scrape one of these days.
I love scrapes. They're the only things that are never serious.
Oh, that's nonsense, Algy. You never talk anything but nonsense.
Nobody ever does. The Manor House. Woolton, Hertfordshire.
Thank you.
Thank you.